Hi, my name is Sebastian from Shonko Music, and I want to show you the next part of my Yamaha A3000 sampler. Besides the sample function and synthesizer function, you have also the possibility to record stuff with effects. If you go with analog input, then you can choose three kinds of effects, three different or three times the same effect. That's interesting. By the I/O extension board, you cannot choose any kind of effect. So for now, I want to show you an echo part, an echo effect. It's called Tunnel. It's a preset. And very interesting is you can use that effect three times if you want. So we listen to that. And the other thing I want to show you is that you have in the full edit mode, you can switch between full and favorite. Favorite is a little bit limited. I have it on effect slot 1. The effect chain is, you see it here, from 1 to 2 to 3. So I turn it off for now. And you have 15 parameter changes you can do. From dry wet balance to reverb time, diffusion, initial delay, HP cutoff frequency, LPF cutoff frequency, the whys, the highs, the depth, the wall vary, reverb delay, density, early refraction, reverb balance, feedback high damp, feedback level. And very interesting is you can go up to 30 seconds of reverb time. That is a very cool feature. So you will hear that. And also the diffusion, it gives a little bit more stereo feeling. And also interesting stuff like the high or the wide or the depth. This is interesting for me because you can create nice kind of echo effects. So these are presets you can choose, but my favorite is a tunnel effect. So we listen to a harp sound and a voice sound. I switch it on and off so you can hear clearly the difference. So we start with the harp sound, first off and then on, the same sequence, so that you can hear and see what I mean. So to better understand and listen how an echo type or effect sounds, it's much more better when you use a single sound. And also very interesting is when you have the dry and to the wet signal. The complete dry signal is without any effect. The wet signal is a complete effect without the dry signal. The dry signal is the instrument. Normally you go into the synthesizer or the sampler or the effects unit. So the preset is dry 14, and I will change that later to completely wet to show you how really sounds the kind of echo we use here. So we go back, tunnel effect with and without echo. And you can hear a clear difference. This is a very nice kind of reverb or echo. So if you change the reverb time until 30 seconds, it sounds also very good for this old sample unit. So first without and then with the echo. It sounds good in my opinion. And now we want to change to the complete wet level so that you can hear what I mean. So. This is a pure echo sound and it sounds very good. So if we change something like the diffusion, this is more mono. It sounds more stereo. And also if you change something like the wise and the height and the depth. So you can create very nice long reverbs. And go back to the dry signal, to the preset, dry 14. It sounds very good. And now let's listen to that setting when you use a voice. So for the most things, the reverb time is too much too long. But if you want to do some atmospheric style or something like that, then there is maybe, in my opinion, a good use for that. So if we change that effect and go back to tunnel, then we have again the preset. You see it here, it's a reverb time. So we listen here again to a voice. I activate it and deactivate it. So, this is my part for the real-time FX processing of audio material if you want to use it beside a sampler as a FX unit. So, and the last thing I want to show you, I talked about that, is you can use three different kinds of effects, or you can use the same effect three times. So I load that presets here, I have to change it, then you change it to the preset settings, and I will activate all three that you can hear. You can also do crazy stuff with it. And the last thing I want to show you is when I switch and go with the reverb time until 30 seconds three times. So listen to that. Sounds crazy, and now we go more crazy. Okay. And I will also switch the diffusion up to 10 so that we have a very stereo signal, good stereo signal effect here. Diffusion. And now listen to that. So I really don't know the need for something like that. But it sounds very interesting. So that's the part from me now for the little FX processing part. If you want to use an echo as an audio input for any kind of signal you want to use from synthesizer, from voice or guitar or something like that, I hope you get a little bit more clear information about this Yamaha sampler, the A3000. And I hope I see you soon. So I have to say bye-bye until the next video.